Honourable Member for Wolseley.
Speaker, I don't know. If I was a younger person in Manitoba, and I wouldn't claim to be one anymore, but if I was, I might be a little bit excited. I might even be a little bit optimistic about what's going on in our province. Just today, we found out the Grey Cup coming to Winnipeg. That's pretty good. We've got exciting new proposals for our downtown, which members opposite left in a shambles. Things turned around there just a little bit. And you know what? I think there's a music thing going on. I think there might be some people coming here to share some of the best musical talent that our entire country has to offer. And wouldn't you know it, Manitoba's gonna be there with our own musical legacy. Can the minister tell us about the great stuff happening in our capital city these days on the music scene? Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. In Manitoba, we speak music and we're proud to be the host of the 2014 Junos. You know, Mr. Speaker, Manitoba is where Canada's heart beats and the industry is stronger than ever. And Mr. Speaker, $71 million to our economy, over 4,300 jobs related to the music industry. And in this province, we're proud to have people representing the industry in such a way where we have many nominations and people have been nominated to receive a Juno. So, Mr. Speaker, we're really proud of Manitoba. Manitoba's where it's at, Mr. Speaker. Today, we announced the Grey Cup. The Premier was there in the announcement of the Grey Cup. We have the Junos. If you left it up to the opposition, Mr. Speaker, there wouldn't be an MTS Centre, there wouldn't be the Jets. There wouldn't be Investor Stadium, and we wouldn't be having the Grey Cup, Mr. Speaker. We wouldn't have the Junos. We would have zero, Mr. Speaker, with where the opposition is. So today, we celebrate. Manitoba's where it's at. Young people know it. We know it, Mr. Speaker, and we're proud to be the host of the Junos. Hey!